Alright, welcome back to the channel. We're getting ready to do some flight testing on the new Esky Eagle from my last video. I actually had a break between rainstorms, so the grass is a little bit wet. But the air was almost dead calm and had a nice overcast sky, which made for a nice backdrop. So I went ahead and took advantage of it and quickly charged up the battery and put in a receiver. You can see my antennas on top of the wing there. I've put in a 2.4 GHz FreeSky D8R2 receiver that I had laying around, bound it to my Tyrannus, and set up a basic 4-channel model. You see there, I just checked my center of gravity just to be sure it was right. We're using the 3S2200 LiPo, which is the recommended battery. And now we're just double checking all the controls, make sure they operate in the expected, the proper directions as expected. And before we take off, I'm going to double check the nose wheel, make sure it steers in the right way with the rudder. So now we're just going to go ahead and taxi out and try out the landing gear, see how it handles the grass. And then we'll be off. And it was a little bit surprising to me how loud the motor was. I assumed it would make a little bit of prop noise with the prop in close proximity to the trailing edge of the wing, like I mentioned in the previous video. But it was a little bit louder than I was expecting. It's a little bit of a screamer. And it doesn't really fit the character of the airplane. It kind of sounds out of place, but it works. So, as you can see, we're in the air now. It got off the ground pretty quick. It's got plenty of power. A little bit more than I was expecting, to be honest. And at center stick, it was dropping the nose a little bit. So at this point, I'm just kind of trimming the elevator and getting that set up so it flies straight. And I never touched a roll trim. The ailerons were spot on, and I ended up giving a few clicks of rudder trim, and we're pretty good now. It's pretty much tracking straight and true, hands off. So we're just gonna kind of fly around a bit and feel it out. You can see here I'm just kind of doing a slow pass to see how it handles with the power down low. And it slows down nicely. And one thing that I noticed right away is how the pitch trim doesn't change at different throttle settings. You can throttle back and it'll descend a little bit, which is kind of a characteristic of having the center of gravity on the forward side of the range, which is what you want for a maiden flight, and especially for a beginner style airplane. A slightly forward center of gravity is better than neutral. It helps add a little bit of pitch stability. But as far as power changes, the throttling up or down doesn't seem to affect the pitch trim very much, which is nice. And I was also a little bit surprised by how responsive it is on the controls, and I'm flying this 100% rates with no expo or anything like that. Just however the linkage was set up in the box, I just set it up and flew it like that. They don't give any suggested control throws. You can see here I'm doing a full throttle climb out just to see, and you can see it's got plenty of power. And while we're up there, we're going to go ahead and cut power and force it into a stall and see if it'll snap and do a spin, but it won't. See there, I actually cut the power and pulled the elevator and forced it to stall, and gave full left, full right aileron and rudder, trying to make it snap and get into a spin, and it wouldn't do it. And as soon as I centered the sticks, it was flying again. So that's stall characteristics are nice. And here we're doing a full speed run, full throttle, and you can see the airplane kind of buffeting around a little bit. That's more me on the sticks than the airplane. You can see it on this second pass here as well. As the speed comes up, and especially with the power on, the elevator does get kind of sensitive. But once again, that's at full rates, 100% rates with no expo. And in a later flight, I actually ended up setting up my dual rates after the video. I didn't get any footage of it, unfortunately, but I flew it with 50% rates, and it flies much better. A lot smoother anyway. And you see there, we were just kind of doing a low approach, and I was kind of surprised at how slow it went with no sign of nearing the stall. And I think this next pass is when I actually landed. Did a quick landing. And you can see it doesn't really want to stop flying and settling. I ended up just chopping the power completely at the end there. And it almost stops in the air before it finally ends. So it slows down very slow. And it floats quite a bit. But we'll talk about that more in just a bit. But like I was saying, I set up dual rates on a later flight that I didn't record. And actually I set up triple rates. I had 4, 75% and 50% rates. And 50% was really smooth. I might do 75% with some expo later. And you see here we're doing another quick landing. A little bit later, better than the last one. Just kind of still getting the feel for it. Feeling it out. Kind of not sure what happened there. Either I was heavy on the rudder or got caught up in grass, but... And we're back in the air. And like I said, as far as the airplane flies really slow on landing, trying to get it to stop flying, it'll slow down a lot, quite a bit. And you can see here we're doing some aileron rolls, just kind of feeling it out. And it handles those just fine with minimal elevator input to maintain altitude. And here we're going to do some inverted flying. And once again, it takes minimal down elevator to keep the nose up. And back to what I was talking about a minute ago, though. When you're slowing down to land to try to get the airplane to stop flying, it actually gets slow enough you kind of lose your yaw authority with the rudder and the yaw stability. It'll start kind of wallowing a little bit left and right. Speaking of yaw authority, you can see there, I just did a quick rudder turn. With the power on, the rudder is quite effective. You see it kick the tail around just fine there for that little stall turn. But on landing with power completely off, and when it slows down to a crawl, you actually lose your rudder authority, and you can maybe... No, not this fast. There's one of the approaches, I was kind of feeling that out at some point in the video. I don't remember exactly where it was, but you'll see it kind of start wallowing around, kind of swinging the tail and the nose back and forth a little bit. But I found it works to keep some power on, just to keep the airflow over the rudder, so you maintain that yaw authority and stability. But that does tend to stretch your glide slope out quite a bit. So it's kind of got its own little traits, and you kind of have to feel it out. There was another little slow approach there with some power on. You can see it tracks just fine with a little bit of power just above idle. But if you get it too slow with no power, it will start kind of hunting a little bit. And that is kind of typical of this design. And the reason for that is there's actually more area on the fuselage in front of the center of gravity than behind it. But you do have a little bit more, the tail moment gives a little bit more leverage to keep the stability. Kind of see a little bit of a rough landing there. That was my fault. I was kind of testing the landing gear. That's my excuse. But anyway, what I was saying is it's pretty typical of this design with the thin tail boom like that. And especially with the prop blast right over the tail with the pusher setup like this, you will kind of get more control authority from your tail surfaces with the power on than with it off. But it's not a problem. It's just it's a characteristic of this design. Yeah, this is the approach. You can see it kind of wallowing a little bit there. And you'll notice there once I powered up, it kind of kicked the nose around and rolled a little bit. It's because I was on the rudder when I powered up, and the authority came back. So it's just something to be aware of. But it's not a problem. But anyway, as far as airplane itself goes, I'm really enjoying it, having a blast flying it, and it looks great in the air, as you can see here, hopefully. It's got a nice little speed range there. It'll slow down to a crawl, or it'll throttle up and move pretty good with the power on, and like I was expecting, with the full 4-channel controls and moderately sized surfaces, you do have a kind of sporty control. It makes a nice little sport model. Now, as far as marketing it as a strictly beginner airplane, I personally wouldn't recommend this one for a first airplane to someone that's never flown in the hobby at all. It's can be fast enough to get away from you and kind of get you in trouble if you're not expecting it, if you're not ready for it. And with the four channel controls, it you may get mixed up a little bit. Now that's not to say that you couldn't learn to fly on this, but I would do it with some help with an instructor. For me, this reminds me a lot of a traditional nitro four channel trainer style airplane. It flies a lot like those, feels like them in the air, and like I said, you could easily learn to fly with some help on this airplane. But if you're gonna go it alone, start out with something simple, cheaper little three channel airplane or something. Once you've mastered that and you're ready for your second airplane, this would be an excellent choice. Like I said, if you dial the controls back, like I said, I'm thinking around 75% rates and a little bit of expo to smooth it out around center stick would be the sweet spot, and it'll be very easy to fly there and still give you enough control authority to get out of trouble. But like I said, this entire video I'm flying on 100% rates with no expo, and I wish I had recorded the second flight, but like I said, I was kind of pressed for time and flying between the rain. So it had actually rained earlier and had some more rain moving in, so I flew two batteries through it, and on both batteries I ended up flying around 15 minutes, and they were at about 3.8 volts per cell at the end of the flight. So 15 minutes is a nice conservative number. I was really expecting it to fly a little bit longer than that on a 3-cell 2200, but hearing this motor in the air, as much noise as it's making, all of that noise is wasted energy, basically. So I don't think it's super efficient. It's pretty high KV rating. I think a lower KV rated motor with a larger prop would probably be better suited for the speeds this airplane flies at, but to do that, you're not going to clear a larger prop with the current setup. To go with a larger prop and a lower KV rated motor, you would need to raise the motor up, which would change the looks and the flight characteristics and everything, and require additional work and stuff like that. So I say just leave it like it is and enjoy it for what it is. You see there, we've just landed, checking the motor temperature and the battery. They were both cold to the touch, so they're not being pushed beyond their limits or anything like that. It's not pulling a lot of current, whatever. But go ahead and fly out the rest of the battery and just kind of do some more touch and goes and landings and stuff like that, and enjoy it. So I guess I'll go ahead and shut up now, and just remind you that if you're not already a subscriber on my channel, I would appreciate it if you would do so. It would help me out, and like I said, I'll have links to the airplane below the video if you want to check it out. They're approximately $110 at Banggood, and Banggood actually sent me a coupon to share with you for 15% off, and if I'm not mistaken, that brings the price down to around $94. So I'll have that too. It'll be right down with the link, and like I said, it will be an affiliate link, so I will get a cut of the money if you use that link and purchase one. It doesn't cost you any extra, it just helps me out. Banggood gives me a cut of the sale, pretty much. So I hope the video has been informative and enjoyable, and if not, let me know what you think I could have done better, and I'll try in the future videos. And if you did like it or whatever, just have some comments or questions or whatever, leave them in the comments below the video and I'll try to answer them. And just kind of a quick heads up, some of the stuff coming up in the future, I still need to do the Talon GT Rebel. I need to fly it now that I've adjusted the control throws mechanically. And I also have a new FPV DVR to try out, as well as the Fox Air Mix, and I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to mount that on, but that's just kind of a quick heads up on what's coming up on my channel. So, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll leave you to it now. I'll close out with a couple of still images that I took after the flight. And keep an eye out, because I will probably be doing some more fun flying with this one. So, enjoy!